Hello everyone, I am here with my Nanny's Attic by Nola design team project, and this is another doily book, and this one is going to be for sale. I am busy working on my swap that I have with my sweet friend, and I'm not going to mention her name right now, but I will show you her book because her book is about halfway done. It's another fiber book. I'm going to tell you a little hint. Anyway, and I also am working on my order, my big order, that I have for my other sweet friends. So I'm busy, busy, busy as always. This that you're looking at is a beautiful anniversary gift from my sweet husband. He asked me what I wanted for our anniversary, and normally I say, just get me perfume, or, buy me something, Uggs, or something that I always need. This time, I've been seeing these everywhere, and I happened to find one at 4 o'clock in the morning the other night while I was on eBay. And it was for half the price of what they normally run. So I snatched it up. And so this is what hubby got me for my anniversary this year. But anyway, oh my gosh, it's a tapestry. It's going to go on my wall. I'm not cutting this up. No way. It's made with beautiful. Let me move my doily books, you can see it's made with the most beautiful vintage. Look at this. It's a square. I think it's about 40, 45 by 45. It's all vintage pieces. And I have been seeing so many people with these on their desktops that I had to get one. So, yay. I'm so happy. I love it. It's all my colors. Purple, green, maroon, black, gold, brown, olive green. I mean, it's like perfect. These are all my colors. And the blue, the teal blue. It's actually darker than it looks on the screen, but it's so pretty. But these are all my colors. Every single one of my colors is there. Even the cream, the brown, the gold. I mean, it's just so beautiful. Look at this. They're all beautiful, beautiful diamantes. And I'm going to take you off real quick so I could give you a close look. Look at this beauty. Oh my gosh. I am so, 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 so happy. There we go. That's truer to the color. So, so happy. It is just beautiful to die for. I mean, it's just absolutely stunning. And I could never afford it. It was like a miracle. That, look at that rose right there. Oh my goodness gracious. That's made from fabric. And this leaves. It's all in my colors. Burgundy and olive green and purple and brown. Gold. Just beautiful. Absolutely stunning. I just love it so, 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 so much. Ugh. Anyway, I wanted to share that with everybody. I'm so lucky. I really am blessed. And this truly was a godsend because there's no way I could have afforded this ever. They're so expensive. I mean, they're just beyond expensive. But it was literally half price. I can't even believe it. Okay, anyway, I'm done. Here we go. Nanny's Attic by Nola. Here is the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful bits and pieces that I get from Nola. This book was created with goodies from Nola. Of course, it's her design team project. I got goodies from Gail. This was a little piece of trim that Gail sent me. I love this so much. And I have goodies from Donna Joseph, Judy Knows, Dawn Marie, Betty Joe sent this, Karen Billinger. She also sent goodies, and I hope I can remember everyone else. oh my gosh, I don't know. I'll remember as I see them. I have goodies from NSK. This was from NSK. Oh, BB Craft. These were bits from my design team package from BB Craft. These bold pins are in my store. And I keep adding new things every day, so run over. I'll have all the links below to Nanny's Attic. I think this was given to me by Nola. It was a big, the end of a half of a scarf, and this is the fringe. So I added that all the way around. This again has layers, layers, layers. This is the first page. Oops. This is the first page, so you can see how thick it is and all the layers. Now, this was, remember that piece that Nola gave me that was a, it was just a ruffle. Let me see if I can find it here on the bottom of my desk. You guys know my desk is always a mess. But I chopped it all up. It was a, I've got all. No. Oh, that's my other doily book I'm working on, the mini doily book. Okay, I don't know where it is. But, hold on, let me look right here. I think I have one more left. My nanny's package. Where is it? Oh, you know me, I'm never ready, guys. I'm sorry, guys. I don't see it. I know it's right here in front of me, too. I just know it is. Hold on, give me 2 seconds. Because I really want you to see. Did I use it all? I might have used both pieces. She gave me 2 pieces of this. Okay, I don't see it in my fabric, so I might have used it. I think I have a little tiny piece left, but I don't know where it is. In my nanny's box. Okay. I don't know. Okay, there we go. Forgot to put up my little sign as well. Okay, anyway, so it was a, see, it's got these ruffles, and it was sewn around, and I just cut it in bits, these layers, and I put it all the way around. Here, maybe you could see it better here. And it was all different sizes, but it's okay. I just added it to the bottom. And I think, yep, this is the scarf. Here. And then that's the doily at the bottom. And then this is the layers for the other, for this underside. So I started with the doily and then the layers and then this. And then this was a piece from Nanny's curtain that she sent me. And then these are just scraps from this. And again, this was from Betty Jo. This was, I think these are from Neri. This was the tutorial, if you haven't seen, from my doily pieces. I made a tutorial on how to make these flowers and this big flower. So you can see close up now. And I added just little bits of fibers and just little pieces of snippets of doily pieces and just little snippets of wedding dress applique. And then this was a beautiful, these beads and these beads, pearl resin pieces were given to me from my sweet friend, Judy Dominguez. May she rest in peace. She died last year along with my sweet friend, Jonine. And may she rest in peace as well. I miss them so much. Little bling chain. This was a little piece scrap from NSK. So pretty much that's it. Let me show you the back. The back again. There's that piece, you see? There it is. Now you can see it. And I just laid it down. I just chopped it all up. And I just love the way it flows. Scraps, all scraps from Nanny's. These are the last little flowers from Nanny's on the bottom. Beautiful. I love this. I love this fuzzy curtain so much. Nola, you got to find another one of these. I'm almost out. I think I've got about maybe a 40 by 30 piece section left of this. I cut it up and I use it for everything. I love it, love it. And I've shared some with friends as well. And then this is just a little, see that? This little piece here. I just put it to the side so the little ruffle hangs out. And then this was a doily that was given to me by Gail. And this was from Dawn Marie. It was a huge, huge table. No, I'm sorry. This was from Nola. It was a huge table. Big round, like a table cover. It had to be at least 20 inches round, but I used a lot. I cut it all up and put that down there. And these were rolled roses that I made from that fabric, which I love, love, love. I've chopped it all to bits, but I love this so much. I got a piece of this. I've made a lot of flowers, and I just added some bits down here. It's so, so pretty. The butterfly was given to me by Mamie, my sweet friend Mamie. She sent me a box of sari pieces. And she's going to be selling them. She's busy making little snippets and things. And once she's done making a good amount so she can sell them, I'll do my video on revealing her bits and pieces. And then I'll send you to her Facebook and she'll have them for sale. Just little bits of flower. I think this was left over from NSK. I got a strip of little, like a beaded, a bling trim, and that was one of the flowers left over. And yep, I think that's it. But see, there's that piece. I just love it. Doesn't it look good? Just flanked there. I just love it. That's what I used out here in the front. Okay. We got to hurry up because I'm already wasting 15 minutes. Good gravy. Good gracious. Good gravy. Okay. I tied the book with tulle. This is my own vintage tulle. I found a skein in one of my yard sales. And as you can see here, I used my doilies as the base. And then I just tied them here. Okay. And all right, now let's go inside. The first page. This is a teddy bear doily book. Okay. And let me see. There's the main doily there. I added some of the beautiful, gathered it up, the eyelet lace that Nola sent me. And then this beautiful, I gotta re-glue that. This beautiful piece all the way around, also doily that Nola sent me. And this is lace that Nola sent, and more of those flowers. I have a few of those leaves left. And then this one is a, excuse me, guys, I'm so sorry. This was a doily from Gail, and this was a piece from Gail. She sent me like a little, where is it at? Like a little chunk. Why can I never find what I need? And she glittered it up, this little piece here. So I just cut them up. She put stiffy on them, I guess. So I just cut them up individually. I don't know if you could see the... Can't really see the glitter. But they're all glittered up. Yep, you can't see it. Anyway, that's what I use there. Right there. And then this was an old lace that I had in my store. I no longer have this one. And then just little scrap bits. These are little scrap bits. This was from my doilies that I did the tutorial on. This one was from Rosella a long time ago. Beautiful piece. And I didn't mean to have that glued down there. Have to clean that up. So you can see the eyelet piece all the way around. More eyelet. Nola's lace, I doubled it up to go around, and more of this curtain here. This curtain here with leaves underneath. This was a little tiny bit that I have left over from a lace that Elegant Embellishments. Wow, drawing a blank. Anyway, Elegant Embellishments. This was an old lace that I, or doily, a flower kit that I had in my store ages ago. It's gone. These are just scraps, lace scraps. That was from Gail along. I have a bag of Gail scraps, and I have a bag of Nola scraps, and I have a bag of my scraps. this is just a little flower that I've had forever, and there's that beautiful fuzzy curtain again. I use it on everything. I really do. I love it so much. And this was just a scrap, and this is just a scrap here. And then, of course, a fabric little bear. So I'll bring you close so you can see all the layers. And that's the second page. Okay. And there's the other pages. Let me open this up here. Okay. This is the next page here. Oh, did I miss? No, that's the front. Okay. Anyway. Okay. So this is a double picture spread here. That's what it looks like, all the layers. And there's the doily. So I used some of the yellow curtaining that Nola sent me a while back. I used the peach laces. I used more of that curtaining. There and there. And then scraps of doilies all the way around. This is a lace from my store here. So I put one here, put one there, and put one there. And underneath, I used a scrap of this. And this was shared by Deb Hendrick, and I just dyed it. She sent me a link to that. This is that pink fabric that I told you I love to cut up and turn into dangles. Look at how pretty that looks. Is that not gorgeous? And I'll show you that. I know where that is. It's right here. This one. And all I do is just cut a length. And then because it's sewn, when you cut it up, this was another one of those, I think it was a shower curtain or something that I found at one of my yard sales. I make out at my yard sales. My darn thrift stores aren't very good at all. But see, is that not gorgeous? Super cute. So that's how I make that. Okay. And this was from Neri. This was from Neri. And then these are my doilies that I cut the centers out of, and I used them to flank the pictures. And let me see, doily pieces, that's around the picture. That's Nola's. And then there's Nola's lace. This is just a little scrap I had. There's more Nola's lace. This is more scrap of Nola here. This trim. Oh no, I'm sorry. Gail gave me this one. Sorry. Gail gave me this one, and Betty Jo gave me these two. She sent me this, and she sent me this. And then this one is from Dawn Marie, this piece here. Okay. So there's that page, and again, she is for sale. I have my information down below if you are interested in giving her a forever home. Okay, then the next page is my floral page. I love to do a floral page, and again, more that has to be short up there. I'll take care of that. There's the doily. And I will glue that back down. I just leave it sometimes so that you can all see how I layer. And then there's this big flower here. And then there's this piece here. I think this was NSK. This is from My Lace, and it's in my store. It's this one. I just coffee dyed it. And I cut these flowers out. And that's what I did there. And then I added the center of a you know, of a doily, and then another, you know, those connectors, and then these are all the flat back and flower trim from my sweet friend Judy Dominguez. This was a beautiful fabric. I love the squares. Oh my God, I love the squares. that I made a bow out of. I think I have a little strip left of this one. I love this so much. And then just more connectors. And this was a little scrap piece. I think Nola sent me that in her pieces of scrap. This was one of those round big doilies, and I'd just been cutting and cutting. And this was a curtain from Gail. And then that's the other side. There's a doily there. So that is the garden page. The flower garden page. And I'll bring it up close so you can see. Okay. And then this guy is the pocket page. And this was made out of these doilies. And these are the doilies that I cut these out of. This doily here. And do I have one laying around? Let me see. I might. Yep, this is it. Okay, so I just cut here and use these for here. And then I use this outside for here. And then I folded this like this. And I put one here, and then one in the center. So we have one here, one doily here, and then one in the center like this. And that forms the pocket. Okay. And again, one of these flowers here for the background. But there's the pocket, and you can see all three doilies there. It expands. And then have more Neri NSK. This is Neri. This was sent to me by Pat S. She hand crocheted a bunch of doilies, and I've been hoarding them, but I'm going to use them little by little. I'm going to save some for me. But she hand crocheted these doilies. And then this was just a little bead cap I had, and I used more of those, that beaded trim in the center. And then this is a Nola lace. It's a double lace. And then that's Gail's curtain. This is Nola's curtain. She sent me these pieces that were cut already. This was Gail. And this one is Kim from Angel Dream Crafts. I bought a grab bag, and so I use some of her snippets. It was filled with snippets. So I use some of her snippets. And then this is one of those big doily, big round doilies that from Nola. And this is another one down here I used all the way around. And this one is some lace that I got from Dawn Marie. And this one is a huge, beautiful doily, also pineapple, that I put all the whole length of this whole book from the top here all the way to the bottom. And that's the bottom piece there. So let me just... And then this top here, these were part of this, the top of this curtain. And I just put all those rings in there. Just, I love the effect of those rings, the way it looks. All lacy. I love the lacy look. And, yeah, I think that's it. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 layers here on the bottom. I don't know how many on the other ones. I didn't count. Not to mention these. But there's that. And then the next page is this one. And again, another flower page. And these were from Neri. These were on this side. This was my square ecru doily that I cut the center out of. And then Bonnie Bird sent me these wedding appliques. And this is my doily again. I just got the edging and I just, you know, turned it and made it like that. Turned it into a flower here. And then there's the center of this one. So the center area here. Judy Dominguez. This is from My Lace in my store. Do I have that one? Let me see. Oh, I don't have one available, I don't think. A piece. So like I say, I always use all my scraps and then I go looking for them. And I can't find them. Because I use them all. Yeah. I don't see it here, guys. Nope. Okay. Anyway. Let's just continue. There we go. Oh, my pretty tapestry is getting all crinkled up. Okay, there we go. Okay, so then there's that lace again from my store, and I coffee dyed it. Oh no, this is avocado. And then there's more of Nola's beautiful leaves, and then there's that big piece, and then we got the other side there. So there's that side. Beautiful, beautiful. I just love this. So pretty. Okay, and then this side I made with the square doilies again that I was showing you. I did a tutorial. Here's the square doily here. And it's this one, right? I just put it down. And remember I told you I made a pocket. That's what I did here, but I used mesh. And I just glued it, the mesh here, and sat it down. And this was from Nola's grab bag. This one is Angel Dream Crafts, Kim. I just dyed it. And this one was an old, really old lace. And this one is from Donna. Sanchez, Donna, Joseph. Good golly. I'm confusing Donna Joseph with Sandy Sanchez. Okay. Donna Joseph sent me this. And I've been cutting it up. She also sent me this. And I've been cutting it up. I'm using them. And she sent me this. And I've been cutting it up. So, you'll see those in future projects. Okay, so Kim, this was a lace that used to be in my store. It's gone. Neri, These were just little bits that I've had forever. I think I got those from Rosella a long time ago. And these two little bits was a little strip about this big. I love this that Gail sent me in her scrap bag. So I've been chopping them individually. And this is Nola's lace. This one is Nola's lace, the white one underneath. This one is Dawn Marie. And this one was in Gail's scraps. And what I did was I turned this into a pocket. I put this there. And I put a little wedding applique in the background so you could see it. See it in there? But it's a nice big pocket that you can, you know, put a picture or something in there. Let's open here. And yeah, there's that page. This was on the other side, the scraps. Okay. And then that's the last page. So this is my doily book for Nanny's Attic by Nola. And I see that my time is up. I hope this didn't cut into two different videos, but what can I do? Okay, so please see all of the information down below in the description. This is for sale. Please email me if you're interested. Nola, thank you once again for allowing me to play with your beautiful and represent your beautiful store and be able to play with your beautiful bits. I just love it. And I hope you all like this doily book, and I've got more projects coming. I'll see you all very soon. Bye, everyone. God bless. Stay safe. Love you all very much. Thank you so much, everyone who shared goodies with me and allowed me to make this beautiful piece. Cupcake.